Bali is probably the most visited place in all of Southeast Asia, but there is a reason behind the madness, and I'm here to show you why you need to book your next ticket to Bali. Starting with number 10, Seminyak is probably the most developed part of Bali. Staying in an incredible villa just like you see here could literally cost you just as much as staying in a 4-star hotel in a Western country.
Money just goes so much further here. While I don't rank Seminyak high for the adventure factor, it definitely has a lot to offer if you're just looking to put your feet up, enjoy some luxury living. Number 9 is Gunung Kawi. Now, I'm probably not saying it right, but this is an incredible temple built into a hillside. The environment is in the lush green forest of Bali, and there's something very unique about being here. You truly feel like you're experiencing some of Bali's history. Next up on the list is Jimbaran, somewhere I had one of the most remarkable sunsets of my entire life. Jimbaran can also be quite touristy. There's a lot of people that go here to enjoy the sunset, enjoy some fresh seafood, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. You can definitely expect to compete with some crowds, but you'll have a remarkable night with some great food. Bali is filled with incredible waterfalls, but the two that stood out the most to me are Tegunagun and Padang Bulia. These two waterfalls are an incredible day trip. Tegunagun is probably the most visited of all the waterfalls, but I'm actually sharing with you a little secret here. Padang Bulia is by far one of the most unknown waterfalls that is worth visiting in Bali. This is truly a local secret and a lost LeBlanc find. This is Ubud. Ubud is a really cool, kind of yogi, easygoing town that has a very unique Balinese culture to it. It's filled with local markets, coffee shops, incredible restaurants, high-end hotels, and even low-end hotels, so it fits all budgets. Ubud is pretty much a must-visit place if you're coming to Bali. It definitely is one of the more popular tourist attractions, so it does get busy. Number 5 is actually a place that's not in Bali, but it's close enough I thought I would include it. These are the Gili Islands. I've visited countless islands in my life, and the Gilis are some of my favorite. There's simply nothing more laid back. There are no cars here. There is only pedal bikes. That basically gives you an idea of the pace on the island. Everything is very slow moving, everything is very relaxed, and you can stay in fairly nice accommodations to budget backpacker accommodations, basically the full spectrum, but definitely expect to spend more money on accommodation, on beer, and on food. Everything will be about twice the price, if not more.
Now, number 4 is somewhere I have never been before. This is Uluwatu. This is a place that people absolutely rave about. Uluwatu is in the very southern tip of Bali, and one of the best things about it is that you have a much quieter environment, but you still have amazing villas, hotels, restaurants, and some of them are even built on the side of a cliff. There's a few very iconic sites here, including cliffside temples, and I highly recommend you add Uluwatu to your list. The footage you see here is not Uluwatu, but it gives you a bit of a feel for the area.
Now, the next on the list is Kuta. And Kuta is actually a place that has very mixed reviews. Depending on who you talk to, some people will say they loved it, some people will say they hated it. Tons of people come here to party, get cheap food, cheap drinks. Essentially, it's the most westernized part of Bali, and it's pretty much the nightlife capital of the island. This is definitely a place that a lot of backpackers like to come, but there are high-end budget people that stay here in the nicer hotels and resorts. It has pretty much everything for every budget. If you're just wanting to get into surfing and you're looking for a great beginner's place, Kuta actually has a beach that's fantastic for that. The waves are very manageable, and you can pretty much go down to the beach and rent a surfboard on any single given day. Number 2 on the list is a place called Canggu, and Canggu or Canggu, depending on how you want to pronounce it, is definitely one of my most favorite developed areas in Bali. It's not off the beaten path, but it has enough of a quiet side that you feel like you're outside of the busyness of Bali, and yet you have a nice surf town feel to it. There's a lot of surf shops because this is one of the best places to catch the great waves that hit Bali. I tried it as a beginner and I got destroyed, but I will not discourage you from trying it. Find everything from entry level to expensive villas and hotels. Similar to Ubud in a sense, it has kind of a laid back feel to it. It's very chilled out. It's the kind of place where you got those really hipstery, trendy coffee shops and restaurants and other beach town feels to it. Nusa Penida. This right here is the hidden gem of Bali, and it might not be staying that way for long. I was there about a year and a half ago before anyone was talking about it, and this place dropped my jaw. Within about a 45-minute ferry off the mainland of Bali, we arrived. this place is something out of a dream. It's been over a year since I've been there, and things have definitely changed. First off, going to Nusa Penida from when I last experienced it, it had a bit of a challenge to it. You're definitely going to want to hire a car to show you around for the day, and I would recommend doing 2 days. The roads are very rough, slightly undeveloped, and quite mountainous. You can definitely try to rent a scooter, but this is one of the few places where I think it does make sense to have a driver. There are two very notable lookout points, this one right here that basically looks like a dinosaur head, and on the other side of Nusa Penida, there's this one right here. Staying in Nusa Penida will definitely cost you a little bit more than the mainland because it's not overly developed, but it is very up and coming, so be ready for more development. I highly recommend you get here as soon as possible because this might not be the same story in 5 years, and these viewpoints might become a whole lot busier.